Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Divine Mercy Sunday. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. Like newborn infants, you must long for the pure spiritual milk that in Him you may grow to salvation. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate the Sunday of the Divine Mercy and also the final day in the octave of Easter, let us turn to the Lord and acknowledging His love and mercy for us, let us turn to Him and ask for forgiveness for our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, His love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, His love is everlasting.
Let the house of Israel say, His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, His mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, His mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, His love is everlasting.
I was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and He has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, His love is everlasting.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, it is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made, let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, His love is everlasting.
A second reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by Him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey His commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. You believed in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen me but still believe. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side, and the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit, whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand inside his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these were written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we mentioned at the start, we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday. And every second Sunday of Easter, which is the last day of the octave, is celebrated as Divine Mercy Sunday. This is instituted by John Paul II back in the year 2000. And I believe this is during the time of the canonization of Saint Faustina. And Saint Faustina was the disciple of the Divine Mercy, because she was the one who the Divine Mercy supposedly appeared to her and gave her all the intentions, in a sense, the instructions, which Pope John Paul II, in a sense, popularized. He was the one who, in a sense, brought our consciousness to the Divine Mercy. He was a very strong devotee and proponent of the Divine Mercy. So here, you realize that you take a look at the Divine Mercy as the mercy of God. Remember, God is mercy. God is compassion. And of course, there are three important symbols that we will reflect on. But the first point is just to understand the Divine Mercy. And then the second one is to say something about the Gospel and how the Gospel also reveals to us the mercy of God. Then the third, maybe just for us to understand also what are the gifts or the graces given to us as we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday. So first about Saint Faustina and the devotion to the Divine Mercy. As I said, the Lord appeared to her and she had visions and messages from the Lord. The Lord had messages to her, and in the form of the Divine Mercy. But I'd like to invite you to reflect on is that the Divine Mercy really, I think, it is, first of all, I think, at least in my own reflection and devotion to it, it reminds us of the mystery of the Incarnation, the first point. And the second point, in the images, there are two rays coming from the heart of the Lord. And here I have my vestments. You have the blue and the red rays, symbolizing the water and the blood coming from the Lord in the cross, when he was on the cross. And then, of course, the Divine Mercy is also a representation of the resurrection. And when you look at that, that completes the mystery of our salvation. From the time of the Incarnation to the Paschal mystery. And for me, that is part of the gift of the Divine Mercy. It is a very powerful image, a very powerful devotion of understanding our salvation. And of course, the incarnation is for me very, very crucial, no? Because I think there is, I think in our religion we have that unique grace, no, of our God taking on the human form, the incarnation, no? And I think that also is very symbolic of the divine mercy, of the compassion of God. Now remember what I always told you, Jesuit Father Keenan, I believe, no, said, mercy or compassion of God is the ability to enter the chaos of another person and to help that person make meaning out of his life or her life. And most certainly the incarnation was the ultimate expression of God's mercy and compassion when he entered our world and entered our human form. No, as Saint Paul puts it in the letter to the Philippians, taking on the form of the lowest form of humanity, that of a slave, that of a servant. No? So it reminds us, the incarnation reminds us of the mercy of God entering our human situation. And of course, that entering of our human situation finds its fulfillment also on the cross and the resurrection. No? So that is the meaning that the Lord gives us because of his mercy, that this is the promise, no, of the fullness of our life, to share in the cross and resurrection and to share in the fullness of our life, in the life of God. No? So that first point to reflect on. No? And then the second in the gospel. No? Again, here you have elements, no, in the gospel. No? First, the risen Lord giving us his peace. Peace be with you. Then second, the risen Lord gives us the Spirit. No? And remember, we kept on talking about our living in the time of the Spirit. No? And here again, no, in the gospel, it reminds us of that, no, by the Lord giving us his Spirit. Of course, the final element, no, that contributes to our understanding and celebration of Divine Mercy Sunday is that he gives the Spirit to continue the mission of salvation, the forgiveness of sins. And he breathes on the church, the Spirit, and gives the church authority to forgive sins, no, and of course to retain them also, but above all, no, to sacramentally, no, bring the mercy of God to people, no? So that second point to reflect on, no, that for me this is really, no, the fullness, no, of the mercy of God entrusted to the church, no, and the Spirit given also in that mission, no, to forgive sins, no. Then the third and final point is the celebration of Divine Mercy Sunday. No, there's some special graces given to it. Of course, many of you did the novena from Good Friday and ended yesterday, no, Holy Saturday, no, and part of the grace is that the forgiveness of sins, no, and then also and there's in 2002, I believe, no, there was the Pope also added to it plenary indulgence, so for those who celebrate the feast, but provided that of course they are sorry for their sins, they go to confession, and then they devote themselves to Divine Mercy, even if you wish, pray the chaplet. No? But these are the extraordinary graces given on the feast day. No? And for me, I think, again, it just talks about, no, our God as a God of mercy, no? And the church acknowledging that, no, by giving all of these graces sacramentally, no, through the Mass, celebrating the Eucharist, through confession. And of course, I think at the end of the day, no, it is really, no, our ability to see now, no, that our God is a God of mercy, that our God is a God who understands everything that we go through. Siguro mahalaga na hindi lamang natin maunawaan ang kapistahan ngayon, ano, ng Divine Mercy, kundi talagang maging bahagi ng ating pananampalataya at ating debosyon, ano, bahagi ng ating buhay panalangin, no. Kasi nga, 'di ba, ito ay pinopularized, di ba, ni John Paul II, dahil nga yung si Sister Faustina ang siyang binigyan ng mga mensahe ng Panginoon, no, ng Divine Mercy, no. At palagay ko bahagi nito ay yung makikita natin yung imahen, di ba, na pinakita ko kanina. Merong dalawang ano, no, sinag galing sa puso ng Panginoon, yung dugo at tubig, no, na nanggaling sa kanya nung nasa krus siya, no. Pero yan ang ano, yan ang simbolo rin ng pagpapatawad ng Panginoon sa pamamagitan ng krus, ano? At syempre ito rin ang Divine Mercy ay lagi natin inuugnay nga sa Panginoon na muling nabuhay, kaya ang panghuling araw ng octave of Easter ay Divine Mercy, no? Siya ang risen Lord, no? So the Spirit of the risen Lord. At higit sa lahat din, mahalaga rin natin balikan yung kanyang pagkakatawang tao. Kasi sabi nga ni Father Kinan, ano ba ang habag o awa ng Diyos? Ito ang kakayahan na pumasok, no, sa mundo ng tao at sa kanyang kaguluhan ng kanyang mundo at tulungan siyang humanap ng kahulugan sa buhay. At dito nga ang krus at muling pagkabuhay ang pinakamalalim nating kahulugan. Ito ang pinakamalalim na kahulugan ng ating buhay, na hindi nagtatapos ang buhay sa kamatayan, kundi dahil sa krus at muling pagkabuhay, pinangako sa atin ang buhay na walang hanggan. Yan ang sukdulang kahulugan ng ating buhay, no? At yung pangalawang punto ay galing sa Ebanghelyo, no? Na makikita natin dito, sabi ng Panginoon muling buhay, anong mga regalo niya? Kapayapaan niya at ang Espiritu na siyang magbibigay ng kapangyarihan sa simbahan na magpatawad ng mga kasalanan. Kaya makita natin, ito rin ay bahagi, no, ng divine mercy. At yung huling punto na nais ko lang ibahagi ay merong pinangako ang simbahan, ano? Nung 2000 at nung 2002 pinalawak 'yan, ano? Yung mga taong talagang nagsisisi sa kasalanan at nagpunta sa kumpisal itong nakaraang octave of Easter bago mag Divine Mercy Sunday or during Divine Mercy Sunday at tumanggap ng komunyon, pinapangako ang biyaya ng pagpapatawad ng kasalanan at ng plenary indulgence. Siguro mahalaga lang na pagnilaya natin to, na ito ang masasabi nating regalo ng simbahan sa mga deboto ng Divine Mercy. So today, let us celebrate, no, probably one of the greatest feasts of our faith, to celebrate once more the mercy of God, because God is mercy. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us turn to the Father, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who plunges us into the infinite ocean of His mercy that is greater than sin, evil, suffering, and death. In His loving mercy, we have victory, salvation, and eternal life. Our response to each prayer is, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the Church, that believing in and experiencing the Lord's infinite mercy, they may always proclaim it to God's people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who, like Thomas, live in doubt and fear, that peace and forgiveness of the risen Christ may strengthen them to face life's challenges and difficulties, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, that we may be immersed in the ocean of divine mercy and live as ministers of the Lord's peace and reconciliation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we pray, continue to pray for the good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, for all his intentions, especially his prayers for peace. And let's also remember to pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and those who have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb that has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for the Easter season. And we will pray this until the last Saturday of Easter, after which we will pray the prayer to the Holy Spirit.
Risen Lord, may the joy of this season inspire us to renew our friendship with you as your companions in mission. Open our mind, heart, and spirit to the truth and grace of sacred scripture, and may the story of the journey of your disciples and the early church renew our own journey of mission in our world today. Enliven our faith that we may do all things in joyful, loving obedience and witness to the saving power of your cross and resurrection. May we be a sign of hope in our world today and bring the victory of your cross and resurrection over the evil of violence, injustice and war, over sin and death. Risen Lord, make our hearts burn within us that we may set our world on fire with the love and mercy of your heart. Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thank you very much for joining us. And also apologies that we were not able to get the total of the Ale Kapwa collection as of this week, no? Because the staff was on vacation and they're just catching up on work this week, no? But again, we'd like to invite you. There'll be links that will be shown and a QR code, no, to join the Ale Kapwa expanded program. This will fund all the anti-poverty, the social action programs of Caritas Philippines and all the dioceses, no. So please consider joining. It's an annual giving fund to commit an amount that you will give every year. You can commit the amount and then sort of divide it into months or quarters. But please consider joining and signing up to become Ale Kapwa partners, no, to fund the different legacy programs of Caritas Philippines. Maraming salamat po for your support, and let's all pray that we may truly become a church of the poor, a church that will proclaim God's mercy, especially as the Lord himself said that he came to bring good news to the poor. Let us be part of that church and that proclamation. And again, continued happy Easter to all and happy Feast of the Divine Mercy. Thank you po. And then please join us also after this for Journeys of Hope. Our guest is Carlos Alvarez he works with Region 4 for the disaster preparedness. So please join us, and also for Proyecto Pilipino. Again, thank you, and have a very joyful celebration of Divine Mercy Sunday. Thank you.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one.
I can't walk on water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.